Have you ever pondered on what exactly the kingdom of God is? Is it a place, a feeling, or perhaps a state of mind? Today, we journey together into the heart of a concept that has been contemplated and debated for centuries, the kingdom of God. But instead of viewing it through the lens of a new religion, we'll be exploring it as a government. The kingdom of God as a government is a concept that has been present since the days of the Old Testament. It was the driving force behind the Lord God's deliverance of the Israelites from Egypt, and the promise of a Messiah in Isaiah only further emphasizes this governmental aspect. This is the foundation upon which the teachings of King Jesus are built. Enter Jesus, a figure whose message was not driven by religious motivations, but rather kingdom-focused. His proclamation of the kingdom of heaven being at hand was coupled with acts of healing and teaching. His teachings were not just about words, but actions, a demonstration of the principles of the kingdom. This kingdom in action is what Jesus taught his disciples to prioritize. The kingdom of God is not a passive state, but an active one, one where its citizens are empowered by their king, protected by the Holy Spirit from the evil one. These kingdom citizens are given exclusive insights, guided by the Holy Spirit. The Lord Jesus often used parables, acknowledging that those with blessed eyes and ears have a depth of understanding reserved for those connected to the kingdom. This concept of the kingdom as a government is reinforced in Jesus's conversation with Pilate. When asked if he was a king, Jesus responded, "My kingdom is not of this world." This statement once again emphasizes the distinct nature of the kingdom, separate from worldly systems. In conclusion, the kingdom of God is a government, a concept present since the Old Testament and a central focus of Jesus's teachings. It is a kingdom in action, where its citizens are empowered and given exclusive insights. The kingdom of God is not of this world, but a distinct entity, separate from worldly systems. So, delve into the four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, from the viewpoint of the kingdom of God, as taught by Jesus. Explore the kingdom not just as a concept, but as a reality. And remember, faith is the key to unlocking the kingdom's secrets. Thank you for joining in on this exploration. If you found this discussion insightful, consider subscribing and sharing your thoughts in the comments. Until next time, keep exploring, keep questioning, and keep growing in your understanding of the kingdom of God.